Hello everyone, welcome to Saransh Biology. This video is not to discuss any chapter in biology, rather we'll discuss about the latest announcement made by CBSE, the exemplar board with exemplar policy for assessment of board examinations in 2021-22. As you all would know that on 5th July 2021, Board has sent a letter to all heads of affiliated schools. It has proposed an elaborate system of assessment considering the condition of COVID. It has taken into account various permutations and combinations and ensured that holistic assessment can be made without any bias or prejudice. We'll have a detailed understanding of what is given and how students and teachers have to act in order to do well at the end of their session. 2020-21 was totally marred by COVID. COVID has got the second wave in April, which led to forceful cancellation of board examination. So here we go with the major announcements, and this proposes special scheme of assessment for class 10th and 12th. The background, the circular number ACAD 51/2021, it proposes that mostly students are relying on online mode of education, but if the condition improves, then classroom transaction may be restored to normal. So considering both the proportion, it has proposed that whatever has happened in 2020-21, that has given school the onus, and there might be certain amount of variability in the result as drafted because the condition varied, the question paper and its level varied, and the assessment also varied to provide a homogeneity, or rather say standardization to the assessment. CBSE has drafted special scheme of assessment for the students in the session 2021 and 22. Let us have a look at them. The whole academic term will be divided into two terms, term 1 and term 2. Both will have its rationalized syllabus of 50%. For term 1, the assessment will take place in the November or December of 2021. For term 2, again, the syllabus will be considered only 50%, and whatever is being asked in term 1 will not be asked in term 2. The assessment will take place in March-April of 2022. Term 1 will comprise of MCQ type question. 90 minute ya 1.5 ghante tak ye pariksha chalengi aur MCQ questions puche jayenge, lekin ye questions bhi thode alag kism ke honge, conventional MCQs nahi honge. Term 2 mein different format ke question puche jayenge. MCQ based mein, there will be case based MCQ. As the whole country is preparing to participate in PISA, where we focus on development of mathematical, scientific and language literacy. Accordingly, the examinations of board will have case based MCQ as well as assertion reasoning MCQ to prepare a student for the need of 21st century. On the other hand, term 2 examination will focus on question of different formats, short answer, long answer. They'll be also based on case-based or situation-based, as well as open-ended short answer and long answer question. Now, very important for both teacher and student to look into, internal assessment. School has extended itself to ensure that students participate in all activities planned, and CBSE gives guidelines and materials for the same. Internal assessment broadly includes periodic tests, student enrichment, portfolio, practical examination, speaking and listening activities, and projects. By and large, all schools are aware of it. Class 9th and 10th has got this mode of assessment. whereby students are provided 3 periodic tests, whereas student enrichment activities are set of activities that provides students with the opportunity to express themselves. Let it be quiz, let it be debate, let it be visual arts, let it be creative submission of certain ideas. These all includes student enrichment. Portfolio creation, as mentioned time and again, student need to have a collection of all the activities that they have done to ensure that they come up with a portfolio, and that has also got some weightage. Practical is an indispensable part of curriculum, especially the science curriculum. That is also to be done. There are many portals suggested like ULA, where online practicals can also be done. Simulators are provided. Speaking and listening activities, because all round development of student is very much important, and it's imperative to have good speaking and listening activities. Then projects, which are given from time to time, that help student to collaborate, to think, to assess, and to evaluate. And the focus shifts from self-learning to group learning. NEP also proposes that there must be shift in the methods of learning so that assessment itself should be a mean of learning. As far as internal assessment for class 9th and 10th is concerned, I have already made you all aware of that. Periodic tests, student enrichment, portfolio, practical work, speaking listening activities, and project. For class 10th, 11th and 12th, they will have internal assessment throughout the year, irrespective of the term. There will not binding of term 1 and 2. And this may include end of the topic or unit test. It solely depends on the teacher. Some exploratory activities, practicals, projects to be given. But this time, board is going to be more stringent on archiving. Why? Because schools would create a student profile for all assessment undertaken over the year and retain the evidences in digital format. Yani, jo bhi assessment student ka kiya gaya hai, usse bahut dhyan se archive karna hai aur digital format mein usse surakshit rakhna hai, jiski maang CBSE kabhi bhi kar sakti hai. CBSE saath hi saath har school ko facilitate karegi ki wo internal assessment ke marks ko CBSE IT platform pe niyamit roop se update karti rahe. Kai baar loss of data, kai baar student not appearing. So that all factors have been considered aur ye pravdhan diya gaya ki CBSE ek unified portal launch karegi jisme har school apne har bacche ke internal assessment ko upload kar legi. To isliye बच्चों के लिए भी बहुत आवश्यक होता है कि वो नियमित रूप से अपने असेसमेंट्स में भाग लें, अपने क्लासरूम में आए और हर गतिविधि में अपनी सहभागिता बढ़ाते रहें. टीचर्स आल्सो मे प्लान द एक्टिविटीज अकॉर्डिंगली. अ डिटेल्ड सर्कुलर, डिटेल्ड गाइडलाइन एंड सैंपल मटेरियल विल बी शेयर्ड सून अलॉन्ग विद द रैशनल सिलेबस. सो नाउ वी हैव अ लुक एट द टर्म 1, व्हाट एंड हाउ. As I have already mentioned, it will have MCQ type questions that will include case-based question, assessing reasoning-based MCQ. Syllabus, time and again I have mentioned, it will be rationalized syllabus that will cover 50% of the whole syllabus. Lekin, exam ke module kaise honge? Question paper will be sent by CBSE with marking scheme. So, standardization is being done. Every student gets similar sort of opportunity to express themselves. Examination will be under supervision of external center superintendent and observers. They'll be duly appointed by CBSE. Jaise ki board pariksha mein hota raha hai, center superintendent aur observer ki niyukti, isse paradarshita aur nispakshita ko badhava milega. Response of student will be captured in the OMR sheet. Optical mark reader sheet, इसमें स्टूडेंट अपने असेसमेंट को मार्क करेंगे और ओएमआर सीट को या तो सीधे सीबीएसई पोर्टल पर स्कैनिंग के बाद अपलोड किया जाएगा या फिर स्कूल उसे इवेल्युएट करेगी और परीक्षा के दिन ही उसे के मार्क्स को पोर्टल पे अपलोड करना निश्चित करना होगा, सुनिश्चित करना होगा. दैट इज अ मैंडेटरी क्लॉज. एंड मार्क्स ऑफ द टर्म 1 एग्जामिनेशन विल कंट्रीब्यूट to the final marks or final score of the student. लेकिन इसमें भी conditions है, क्या स्थिति ऐसी ही बनी रहेगी, क्या बच्चे दोनों टर्म की परीक्षाएं दे पाएंगे, क्या एक टर्म की दे पाएंगे, या बच्चे घर से आके परीक्षा दे, घर रह के परीक्षा दे पाएंगे, इन सब के बारे में भी सीबीएसई ने बहुत डिटेल्स में एनालिसिस किया है और हमें बहुत अच्छे सजेशंस दिए हैं और गाइडलाइंस दिए हैं. टर्म टू जो कि 50% सिलेबस पे बेस्ड होगा और इसकी परीक्षा मार्च अप्रैल 2022 में ली जाएगी, अज्यूमिंग कंडीशन गेट्स बेटर. क्वेश्चन पेपर के फॉर्मेट एमसीक्यू नहीं होंगे, अलग फॉर्मेट होंगे. इसमें केस बेस्ड, सिचुएशन बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस पूछे जाएंगे, शॉर्ट आंसर, लॉन्ग आंसर, ओपन एंडेड शॉर्ट आंसर्स एंड लॉन्ग आंसर क्वेश्चंस भी इस प्रश्न पत्र के भाग रहेंगे. सिलेबस रैशनलाइज्ड टू 50% ऑफ द ओवरऑल. यहां यदि परिस्थितियां प्रतिकूल रहती हैं, इफ द कंडीशन इज एडवर्स, देन अगेन सीबीएसई माइट गो फॉर अ 90-मिनट एमसीक्यू बेस्ड एग्जामिनेशन. क्वेश्चन पेपर विल बी सेंट बाय सीबीएसई with the marking scheme. Examination will definitely be conducted under supervision of external center superintendent and observer. Evaluation will be done at school level and marks of the term 2 examination will contribute to the final overall score. Now, we would consider various probability. So, different situations ki baat karte hain. To aaiye ek ek karke un situations ko samajhne ki koshish karte hain aur dekhte hain kitna shandar असेसमेंट स्कीम प्रपोज किया है सेंट्रल बोर्ड ऑफ सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन ने. यदि पैंडेमिक में सुधार हो जाता है और स्टूडेंट्स सेंटर पर आकर दोनों परीक्षाएं लेते हैं, सो वी अज्यूम द थिंग्स गेट्स बेटर, ऑप्टिमिस्टिक एंड रियलिस्टिक, दैट मींस विक्ट्री ओवर द कोरोना. सो इन दैट केस बोर्ड विल कंडक्ट टर्म 1 एंड टर्म 2 एग्जामिनेशन एट द स्कूल और द सेंटर्स एंड दैट विल बी अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ superintendents and observer. ऐसे में theory marks will be distributed equally between the both terms. यानी दोनों term में theory के marks term 1 और term 2 बिल्कुल बराबर weightage लिए होंगे. आइए देखते हैं दूसरे condition को. Corona की स्थिति अगर नहीं सुधरती है और November December में जैसा कि आशंका व्यक्त की जा रही है कि third wave will hit in August September. So that is just a speculation. Then too, considering this probability also, जब term 1 exam नहीं हो पाएगा और बच्चे इसे घर से देंगे, online or offline from home, but term 2 exam will be held at schools or the center. यानी परीक्षाएं तो दोनों ली जाएंगी, लेकिन एक परीक्षा बच्चे घर से appear कर पाएंगे, online mode में appear कर पाएंगे या offline mode में, depending on the school's feasibility, but term 2 exam will be held at the school or the center. इस परिस्थिति में term 1 MCQ based examination would be taken online offline mode from home, but weightage of term 1 will be reduced. और examination के marks calculation के purpose से term 2 को ज्यादा weightage दिया जाएगा. So final result will have more weightage for term 2. Just to normalize the condition. So you see here out, term 2 coming up with more weightage. It will be declared by the examination section from time to time. Teesra condition, complete closure of school during March and April 2022, considering for the worst. But term 1 exams are held at the schools or center. Yani, bachchon ne term 1 exam school aakar diye ho. Aise paristhiti mein, result, performance of the student in term 1, MCQ based examination or internal assessment or weightage of term 1 will be increased and weightage of term 2 jo bachche ghar se lenge, offline or online, that will go low. So, weightage of term will go on higher side and the result will be declared accordingly. Ek aakhri situation ki baat kar lete hain, complete closure of the school throughout and board conducted term 1 and term 2 exam are taken by the candidates either at home or online. Is paristhiti mein jo abhi tak bacche karte aaye hain, board has got clear cut directions. Internal assessment, practical projects, inke marks or थ्योरी के मार्क्स टर्म 1 एंड टर्म 2 उनको ध्यान में रखा जाए और मॉडरेशन कमेटी बच्चों के निरंतर प्रोग्रेस के चार्ट को ध्यान में रखते हुए मार्क्स को मॉडरेट करेगी ताकि वैलिडिटी और रिलायबिलिटी बेहतर हो सके। और सभी केसेस में डाटा एनालिसिस और बच्चों के निरंतर परफॉर्मेंस को ध्यान में रखा जाएगा ताकि इंटीग्रिटी ऑफ इंटरनल असेसमेंट एंड होम बेस्ड एग्जाम कैन बी अपहेल्ड। सो हियर वी फाइंड टर्म टू हैविंग इक्वल वेटेज वेयर एज इंटरनल असेसमेंट ऑल्सो कम्स इन टू प्ले, इंटरनल असेसमेंट बींग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉम्पोनेंट। सो आई विल अपील टू ऑल माई डियर स्टूडेंट टू बी वेरी एक्टिव एंड टू टेक सिंसियर पार्ट इन ऑल एक्टिविटीज। ये मूल्यांकन सिर्फ करिकुलम का मूल्यांकन नहीं है वरना आपकी एबिलिटीज को भी ध्यान में रखकर किया जाता है जिससे जो रिजल्ट्स आपको मिलती हैं वो अनबायस्ड और वैलिड हो। सो विद दिस आई एम वेरी श्योर मोस्ट ऑफ द डाउट्स वुड हैव वैनिस्ड। इन केस यू हैव गॉट मोर डाउट यू कैन राइट इन द कमेंट और सेंड मी द मेल सो दैट आई कैन टेक अप separate videos and discuss those modalities in details. For now, I'm very sure COVID is not gone yet. So the best thing is to maintain COVID appropriate behavior, washing hands regularly, wearing mask, keeping social distancing and vaccination for those age group where it applies. And I'm very sure vaccination will be coming very soon for the younger people also. कहते हैं जब तक पूरी दवाई नहीं तब तक कोई ढिलाई नहीं। With that, I would like to take your permission to wind up the video and wish you good health and good academic session 2021-22. Take care, keep watching, good day.
Students, keep ahead of your friend by subscribing the channel and hit the bell icon to get notified if there is a new video coming your way.